community resilience is really the ability of a community to respond to, absorb, and adapt to any kind of challenge that it might confront.
So what the community of Neskowin, which is a small community where only about 20% or 30% of the people live there year-round, and the rest are second homeowners, came together at a large community meeting. It was on Labor Day, and the community asked the Board of Commissioners, which is three commissioners, they said that we're having significant coastal erosion issues in our community, and we would like help in addressing those coastal issues. And because they're an unincorporated community, the governing body is the county commissioners. So we said, okay, what would you like us to do? And they said, well, we don't exactly know for sure yet because we need to do a lot of research. So we formed a committee called the Neskowin Coastal Hazards Committee, which was made up of local citizens, county, state, and federal folks, and brought them together. And the first thing we did was develop a mission statement and objective statement. And essentially the mission statement is pretty simple. It was to protect the beach and to protect the community at the same time and look for both short and long-term solutions to the significant coastal erosion that was happening in the Neskowin area. And so the second thing we did was we said, okay, let's go out and gather all the research that we can to help us, to give us the facts and figures about coastal erosion and why it's happening and what it looks like in the future. And from that, we sat down and said, okay, we want to develop two philosophies. One is called active protection, in other words, hard kind of things, hard structures, those kind of things. And then land use. The land use measures, the Department of Land Conservation and Development provided a grant to develop what we call a framework plan that looked at potential land use measures that you could consider. And then the community took those land use measures. I think there was originally 19, they narrowed it down to 11. And then the committee itself brought those back to the community in a public meeting, presented those to the community and says, which one of these are the most important to you, or which ones would you like us to continue on? Because we didn't want the committee to say, this is what we're going to do. We wanted the community from the ground up to say, here's the land use measures that we would like the county to consider. And these are regulations that restrict a person's property rights or tells a person what they can and can't do on their property. So it's pretty serious. So they narrowed that down from 11 to 7. And it includes such things as if you build a home on a vacant lot in the hazard zone, and the hazard zone is the beachfront that could be inundated by coastal erosion, that you may have to do things differently than your neighbors did. In other words, you may be required to, if you're going to build a home, to not build it on a slab. It has to be potentially be able to be moved back. It may require that your home be put on pilings. It may require that you have a liability waiver, all of those kind of things. This is actually the community stepping up to the plate and saying, we acknowledge that we have issues and we know that we need to do something in both the short term and the long term, and we are interested in developing our own solutions in compliance with state law. These are in addition to state law, and identifying restrictions that help us to protect the beach and maintain the community. Recently, our Tillamook County Planning Commission voted unanimously to adopt the land use recommendations for the small community of Neskowin. So the success was, is once the agency saw that this community was truly engaged from the bottom up, they were able to provide some of the expertise. So we were able to use the science and develop the potential rules and regulations that got adopted by Tillamook County to get the end result, which is where we are today with this template for the community of Neskowin. And what's pretty positive about it is the community of Neskowin seems to be very, very supportive of the results of this. The Department of Land Conservation and Development has said that they would like to use these recommendations as a template for the rest of the state of Oregon for addressing coastal erosion issues up and down the entire coast. And so essentially it is options that still allow for a private property to maintain their private property and to develop their private property, but they have to do it in a way that addresses coastal erosion issues. So, I mean, it's a trite term, but it truly is a win-win. It allows the property owner to develop their property, but they have certain restrictions that they have to do. For example, slab-on-grade concrete to elevate their structure, to keep it away from the erosion hazard zone, those kinds of things. And so it truly ended up being a success, and it potentially is a great opportunity for the rest of the Oregon coast to address coastal erosion issues. So it's not just the current issues that we're facing right now. It means that potential for a subduction zone earthquake and tsunami, it addresses those kinds of issues, and it addresses climate change over the long term.
It's a mindset shift, it's a management shift, it's a cultural shift that we're going to have to make in terms of the conversation about lifestyle. You know, I mean, some of those things are really tough, right? And but until we see communities that accept that and embrace that, I think we're going to be challenged to meet these challenges. We'll be challenged to achieve resilience. Because it's about behavior modification. It's about thinking about the world differently.
From what we're hearing from people is, let's do something at all. Let's raise awareness. Let's get community engagement. Let's get thinking about climate change into our plans and activities. And let's make sure next year we do it again, and the year after we do it again, so we have an ongoing thing.